No spirit can operate on earth until there is a body that cooperates with it. It's not about sickness. It's not about infirmity. It's a search for bodies. It's a search for vessels. When Jesus was about to rebuke the spirit in the man in Gadara, all the spirits, they said, look, the only reason why we can function in this territory is because there is a body. Now, at least help us minimize the punishment as you banish us from this body. Don't banish us from the territory. Why? So that peradventure, if that man becomes available, we can return. I'd like you to pray. I sanctify my body. I decree and declare, it cannot be an instrument of sickness. It cannot be an instrument of infirmity. Lift your voice and pray. I speak to my blood. I speak to my blood. I speak to my bones. I decree and I declare, in the name of Jesus Christ, the same spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwells in my mortal body. The same spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwells in my mortal body. The same spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwells in my mortal body. I cause sickness. I cause the eaters of flesh and the drinkers of blood. I cause the drainers of life. My body is sanctified. Mato sekete rekata. Pray. Seketeketekete. Seketeketekete. Reketeketekete bakatosh. Manta bakoto peketea. Rakatos soto peketea. I cause spells, I cause enchantments and divinations. Their projections will not find expression in my body. I declare that I am immune, sanctified, immune, above divination, above necromancy, above projections. No manipulations with the stars will project sickness to my body. Pray. I challenge sickness. I call you by your name and I banish you from my body. I call you by your name and I banish you from my family. I call you by your name and I banish you from my environment. Make sure you are praying. Shabratika to Zebres. Lakata praskato pashia. You have a little child, lay your hands on them. I sanctify you. Sato soto bekea. No sickness, no infirmity, no untimely death. In the name of Jesus. My body is a temple. Shekatos koto prakata. Divinity resides in my body. Matatako soto brende kete la kataya. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. One last prayer point. That whosoever digs a pit must fall into it. I'd like you to declare, open your mouth and curse the human entities that partner with spirits to project evil over the lives, the bodies of men. Don't keep quiet. Open your mouth. Shobe ketalia skata. Rekete kete kete. Shabakata kata kata kata. Lepros koto bariata kata. Mande so sedekia. We close the heavens over them. We frustrate their counsels in the name of the Lord Jesus. The church of the Lord Jesus is alive. We are not weak. We are not beggarly. There is an anointing upon us. We represent heaven in this territory. Therefore, we define borders, we define spiritual borders for the activity of evil.
thus far have you come, no further shall you go. We pass a decree, we legislate in the spirit, in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Before you sit down, let me teach you something. You see, we're teaching on the dominion mandate. We'll get there shortly. But every time you watch evil loom around your life and you keep quiet and keep silent and hope it will change, you have made the biggest mistake. Are we together? Evil never lives by itself. Are we together? Don't wait until it happens too late. From the onset, attack it immediately. Attack it immediately. Are we together? Your phone is missing. Tomorrow your laptop is missing. Next tomorrow your shoe. Don't wait. Already you know. You are sensitive. Close your door. Blast in tongues for 15 minutes. Let me tell you something with Satan. Satan experiments. He pushes something and then sees your depth of spiritual sensitivity. When you are carnally minded, you will look for foolish explanations and then he will suspend it for a while so that you don't pray. He attacks an issue. When it's about to get too much, he knows you will pray, so he will relax. You will remain in that condition, then he brings another one. Before you know it, you have been eaten over by darkness. Whether it is in the middle of a night, you turn and it looks like you felt something on your face. Listen, let me tell you, I won't tell you to do something I'm not doing. Go and ask the devil. You wake up and there is a wicked dream, an evil dream. You went to sleep after prayer. You are in a period of fasting. Then he mocks you. You lie down to sleep and you see someone comes to sleep with you, or one kind of nonsense. Then you just stretch and say, no problem. No, light or no light, worship or no worship, charge yourself. Call the spirit by name. Listen, let me tell you, when men sleep, things happen in this realm. I have told you, you lie down to sleep and men make incantations, attempting to project your spirit to realms so that they plant things and you return back. You wake up with things you did not sleep with. Are we together? We'll pray again. One more prayer. Just one more prayer. I like you to pray and say, enough is enough. Whether you know the name of what is happening to you or not, blast in tongues. The word has come. It's my season of triumph. Sheketekata. Mysterious disappearances of items, mysterious coincidences of bad luck. Mato soto brigatai. Pray online, pray outside. I sanctify my borders. I crush the gates of Leviathan. I cross you in the name of Jesus. I lift up the standard of the blood. I invoke the blood. I invoke the blood. I command the elements of creation to stop cooperating with any human agent that uses the elements of the supernatural to project evil to men. We curse you. We curse you. We curse you by the God of heaven. Hallelujah. The Bible says resist the devil. It didn't say discuss. It didn't say hope. It didn't say wish. James 5:13 says, is anyone among you afflicted? Let him pray. That's it. That's a requirement.